Yo, what's up, boys? Today I'm going to be showing you how to edit a Fortnite montage inside of Premiere Pro. Before we start, make sure you like and subscribe and head into the description to follow my Twitch and join my Discord server. But apart from that, let's get straight into the video.
Alright, so the first thing you want to do is drag in your clip. I've gone for Aaron Smith's Dancing Chrono Remix. You normally want to go for a song that is doing well at the time. It's quite popular because then your video will just automatically get more views with the song title. I'll clear these markers. Next, you want to go to the end of the... Oh, actually, before you do that, go to sequence settings. Make sure this is on 60 frames per second, 1920 by 1080. If you don't do that, your whole video is going to be messed up, so just do that. Go to the end and make sure that the track ends where the song ends. So in this case, it does. I'm just going to make this a bit quieter. In this case, it does, but sometimes the song will end here, but the track will end here, so you just want to cut it to where it actually ends. To do this, zoom in and out to the timeline, hold Alt and scroll up to zoom in or down to zoom out. That just makes it easier than having to do this. So next, we want to move this down to A2, audio 2, so we can put in our clip. I like the first clip to be a win, because it just makes the video look better, basically. Alright, so once you've got your clip in, if you play on stretched, then your clip will have black bars. If you don't, then just skip to the time on the screen right now. But if you do, carry on watching to get rid of the black bars. So uncheck uniform scale, make sure it's not checked. Click here, like double click. On the actual video, to the like zoom level, go to 150, scroll left, and then bring this out. You don't need to hold shift or anything. Don't hold shift or anything. Just bring it out to the right place, and then go to fit, and then you can see that it's like this. All right. So once you've done that, under video, go to motion, right click, save preset. And you can just save it to whatever you want it to be called. Stretched. I can't spell stretched. How do you spell stretched? I think that's right. Go to OK. And then if you go to effects, you can see under your presets that... did I save it? Stretched. Oh, here we go. Under your preset. Not, it'll be under this presets here normally. But there'll be something called stretch now. So if you drag in another clip, for example... right there, you can see black bars, but if you drag on the preset stretched, then it will do that for you, providing that these two clips have the same, you've played on the same res for both of the clips. So yeah, you can make a preset to do that. You don't have to do it every time. This is a preset folder, by the way. I'll put it in the description, so you can do the same edits, obviously. So next, you want to go to the drop of the song. So that is a drop, but I don't think it's drop enough. Like, I don't think it drops enough. That's definitely a drop. So we'll go to where it drops. So there. Zoom in and out with Alt. Scroll up, down, by the way. Click on the song. Right click up here where the timings are, and click add marker, and that will add a marker for you. Then you want to go to where you got the kill or the win. As I said, I like to start off with a win, which makes it look better. I'll show you how to do effects for a win and a kill, so yeah, don't worry about that. You want to go to the first frame where you don't have a HUD for a win. So the HUD is all this stuff. Points, health, map, augments, mats, guns, everything. That's what your HUD is, so... just want to go to the first frame. You can use right and left on your keyboard to go frames, play switch frames. Just find the first one. So obviously you can see this is the first frame where I don't have a HUD, because if I go left once, there is a HUD. So just go to the first one where there's a HUD. Make sure you're on the track, add marker. Shorten this. So go to the edge of the clip, get the red thing, make sure it's on the left side, by the way. And just bring it like that until the marker, and that'll snap in for you. And then just bring that, this will snap in also, to the song marker. And then bring this out to where you want the song to, where you want the clip to be. So I missed a shot there. I don't want that to be in, so we'll just get me running away. And obviously this will be synced now. There you go, that's synced. So what we want to do is make a copy of this. Hold Alt. Oh, wait. Hold both of them by dragging. Hold Alt and go like this. And this is this is only if you have a different part of the clip that you want also. So I have a kill in the same clip which I want. So I'm gonna cut that out. So we're gonna get it before the edit. So press C on your keyboard and cut it right there, and that will cut it. You can drag both of them, delete them, and just play the clip out until you want it to finish. There you go, that's where I want it to finish. So press C, click on it, click on that as well, press V and delete this part. V, C is to go to the cut. What do I do? Okay. C is to go to the cut tool. V is to go to the mouse. If it doesn't work, by the way, just go to these. Razor tool is C, selection tool is V. Go to the selection tool. Oh, why isn't this linked, man? If they're not linked, by the way, if they're separate, just highlight both of them, right click and link, and then that'll be together. So you can put them together now. Right click, apply default transitions. We can do that for both of them. There you go, that looks better now, that looks way better. So we have my ident here. You can have an ident, obviously. I think most people have an ident now. You can have an outro as well. Some people don't have an outro, some people do. I just like to have it because it shows, didn't mean to do that. It shows my name and videos and my, it just promotes more basically at the end of the video. So once you put that ident in, put it into just before the clip starts, and that will snap in for you. Bring this out to the start of the ident, and then press C, cut that, and that can go. And then you can fade all of these in by going to the get the red thing, right click, apply default transitions, do this, just do that for everything at the start, and that'll fade everything in, as you see here. There you go. And then if you go to Control A, go to the start, and then just bring everything to the start, and that just brings everything to the start. So when you render, you don't have any black at the start. So once you've got that faded in, you can cut it at the end of the ident. Click on the gain clip, effect controls, and bring the opacity down to 30, and that just makes this darker. And then you can right click, apply default transitions in the middle of these two at the end of the ident, so it fades out like that. Next, we're going to put some effects. Go to where the thing is, hold Alt, and where it says V1, just scroll up until you see this little marker with the two arrows. Click on the clip, right click, show clip keyframes, time, remapping speed, and that allows us to put velocity on it. So if we go two frames to the left of the win, by using the arrow keys, you can add a keyframe. Go back to where the win is, drag this little keyframe out, bring it to 250, and that will speed it up before it slows down. Press 1, go 1 right, only 1 keyframe. Go to 50, and then as you can see, it goes to 50. There we go. And then you want to cut it where you think it's played out for long enough. So. That's been played out long enough, so we can cut it there. And then we want to cut this there. We're going to put some build up on it, so obviously you'll have this these yarn presets. So go to where you feel suitable for the clip to build up. I'd probably say about here, probably about there, and you'll have opacity build up, put that on the clip, and the saturation build up, put that on the clip, and then you will have a build up for your kill or win. There you go. So you see the opacity goes down and the clip gets more black and white, as you see. You can also cut the audio, so the song, where the build up is, get the underwater preset and put that on the song, and that will just make the song sound like it's underwater. If you can listen, see the water, the, not the water, the song changes. Normally I like to put a little fade in it. So if you right click in between, apply default transition, go to the edge of the transition, get the little fade, the like how long you want it to be, to make it about that white, so it fades, it sounds a bit better. Fade sounds a little bit better. Now you got that, you want to put the effect on this. So now you've got a velocity, the first thing you want is a bit, you want to make it a bit brighter basically. So if you go to your matching color, you don't need a, you will need Sapphire FX for some of these, but you don't need it for this one. Drag it onto the last clip, obviously. Go to effect controls, basic correction, and then go down to saturation here. With this, you can, well, if you clicked on the clip, you can change the time in the clip. So if you go to here, click on it, and just make it like 250. And you can see it's made it a lot brighter. But you don't want the whole clip to be bright, so if you go to where the middle of the clip, where the circle, where the glow is, go up and click on the circle for the ellipse mask on the Lumetri color, and this will make it so only the circle, like the glow, is has the Lumetri color, if that makes sense. So you want to hold shift and just make it bigger. There we go. I think that's pretty good. Make it maybe a little bit smaller. Make it a tiny bit bigger than the actual thing. So that means when you go to feather, if you hold it and drag right, then it'll make it bigger. If you hold it and drag left, it'll make it smaller. So if you drag it right, that was definitely a bit too big. Until this inside line here, you can see it's just outside of the glow, and that makes it so only this glow has the Lumetri color. So if we were to hide it, you can see it doesn't glow as much, but it glows more when it has the Lumetri color, so that just makes it look so much better. We'll play it. So yeah, that looks all very good. Now we can add these presets. You will need Sapphire for this. So you can actually buy it, but no one does that really. You can just get it on free on YouTube somewhere. Go God Impact. Tilt Shake. And Flicker. And this goes red. So some people have this problem, some people don't. This will go red once you put Sapphire effects on it or any other custom effects. Like, that's not integrated into the original version of Photoshop. So what you want to do, if it lags when you're playing it, like mine does there, it just freezes. What you want to do is go to the start of the red, press I, go to the end of the red, press O, go to sequence, render into out, and that will render everything inside of the markers, and then it won't lag when you're previewing it, basically. It takes a bit of time, but it's worth it so you can rewatch your clip, basically. So if we, and then once you've got this highlight bit, right click where it's highlighted and just go clear and then out. So we go to the start of this sequence, then we'll see what it looks like altogether. Sometimes the item will be made in After Effects as well, so yeah. There you go, that's what it looks like. So I think that looks pretty good. Next you want to go to zoom out one, drag that on, it'll go red again because it's a sapphire effect. But you can leave it because you've already watched it. The next one to get your next clip. So let me have a look through my clips and I'll be back. So for the first part of the montage, you normally want one pumps. So like one shot kills, which because it just makes it more, it makes it flow better. But towards the middle of the song where there's not as many beat drops, and towards the end of the song, you can have clips like this, where it's more sequenced. But it's more like, it's not one shot basically, so I hit him there once and then box. So you can edit that to make it look better, as I showed how to do before. But yeah, for the start you normally want clips like this, which are more fast paced because it's just one hit. Quick box, one hit, so that makes it look better. So if you go to your clip, go to project, go to your clip and just drag it in there. And then that'll be there. Drag that in, go to the next beat drop. So yeah, just find, oh, you wanna put the preset on this one before you do that. Find the drop. There you go, that seems to be where the next drop is. So then we find where the kill is. So with the kill, you wanna do it where you first see the shield. So there you go, that's the first time we see the shield. So click on it, add marker, and then just bring it like that. Snap it on, bring this out to where that was before, and then you can see the whole sequence. There you go, so it's not fast paced obviously. It's not a long sequence of boxing and stuff, if that makes sense. So we've done that now. So if you zoom in, to where it's synced. It's already, the clip is already bigger, so we can right click, show clip frequency, timing, wrapping speed. Go two back, we've already done this, so I'll do it a bit quicker. Drag, go 250. Click once, go right, one frame, drag, down to 50, and that will give us velocity. There you go. Now, you wanna cut it there, and just obviously cut it where you think it's been played out long enough. So after about probably there, it's been played long enough. You don't really want to play longer than that much. So once you've done that, do the build up again. So just find a suit. It's normally once you've placed or edited the last thing, so that's been placed now. So we'll do that. Opacity, saturation. There we go. So then you can do the underwater thing again if you want to. You don't have to do this, but I think it just makes it look a bit better. You can also do it for the eye den. Cut it there, just put underwater. I don't like it that much, so I just leave it. Go back to your clip. Now that you have build up, have a look. There you go. So you want to put some effects on this, basically, this clip. So if you go to God Impact, Tilt Shape, Flicker. Then put the zoom one. Okay. And then if we go to the first little section of the clip, put zoom out two. So that is, this clip has zoom out one, that's two, so that'll make the transition. And then if you just render this whole thing. So now we can watch the whole sequence. By the way, to make the preview whole screen, full screen, press control and the I don't even know what it's called. This button. My thing won't even. That button there. I'll zoom into it and edit. This one here. The tilde or something like that. Control and tilde. If that's even right. And that will make the thing on screen. So let's watch this sequence. Effect. Fade. Not fade, transition. There you go, that's how it looks basically. So that's done there. So then you just carry it on. But instead of using God Impact, Tilt Shake and Flicker, you can use this Rainbow Glim. Don't use the black buildup. I don't know actually why that's still there. I'll take that out for you. That won't be in there. I don't tend to use XYZ Shake, saturation plus pre-build shake. I don't used to use them three or dip to black build up. Don't used to use them for a lot. But you can mess around with it. You can find a good style for how you like editing. This is just the style I found myself to how I like editing. You can use this Rainbow Glint instead of God Impact. Well, you need the impact for shake, but you can use Rainbow Glint, God Impact, and Flicker instead of adding the tilt shake, or instead of adding Flicker, don't just leave out the Flicker. So yeah. That's how you edit montages in Premiere Pro. Alright, this is what the thing looks like one more time. So I think that's pretty good.
So guys, I hope you learned how to edit a good montage in this video. Make sure you like and subscribe. Also, join my Discord server and follow my Twitch because I stream a lot on there. But apart from that, peace out.